Welcome to Gentec-EO USA here in Portland, Oregon. My name's Don Dooley. Today we're going to walk you through the setup and use of our unique high-resolution Beamage cameras. First, let's take a look at what you get when you buy a Beamage camera. A Beamage camera, an 8-foot length of locking USB cable, an SMA to BNC connector, a certificate of compliance, and a CD with software for both cameras, USB drivers, and a comprehensive user guide. Now, before we make connections, let's look at the features of our Beamage cameras. The camera includes two connectors, first a USB 3 connector, and then a small SMA connector, which is used for an external trigger when using the camera with your pulsed laser. In addition, it has a 1/4-20 threaded hole that's used to mount your camera to your optical table. And last, it has an ND4 filter, which provides protection to the sensor and prevents photocurrent saturation. This can be easily removed and replaced with other filters or optical accessories as necessary. Now let's go ahead and make connections. I've already set up the Beamage 4M camera with a low power laser diode. First, let's plug the lockable end of the USB cable into the camera and make sure you secure it. Next, we'll plug the other end of the USB cable into the USB 3 port on our computer for maximum performance, though both of our cameras will work with a USB 2 connection. That's it. We're ready to bring up the Beamage software. We'll click on the Beamage icon to start the software. The first thing you'll see is a small window where it says searching device. In a few seconds, you'll get another window, Beamage selector. Here, you'll see an ID number for the Beamage 4M camera and other cameras if more were attached. Note that an indicator LED on the camera will light up solid green once the camera is located. Now we'll select our camera by clicking on the OK button. Next, look at the upper left-hand corner of the screen to confirm that the connected indicator is green. Software and camera are now connected. We'll now click on the Start Capture button. The camera will start capturing your laser source, and the software will begin to display it as a beam profile. It will take a few seconds for the auto exposure to set the camera correctly. Let's select the Setup tab, where you can see the exposure time window. When finished, if the exposure time shown is at 200 milliseconds, your laser power is too low, and you will need to remove some attenuation. If, on the other hand, the exposure time is 0.06 milliseconds, your laser power is too high and you'll need to add more attenuation to avoid saturation. Let's move on. The next thing you need to do is to subtract the background radiation. So we'll click on the blue Subtract Background button. You'll get a window that asks you to block the beam. So block the beam and then press OK. Another window appears that asks you to please wait. Once this disappears, you can remove the beam block. Note, make sure to use a beam block material that is totally opaque and does not transmit the laser light. At this point, I'm going to use the zoom feature to enlarge the 3D display. And then I recommend you employ the normalize button. By clicking on it, you will maximize the display resolution. Now let's return to the home tab, where you can select the definition of beam diameter. You have four options: 4 sigma, full width half max, 1 over e squared, or 86% effective diameter. We'll stick with the 4 sigma. I'll scroll down where you can see the measured values for beam diameter and position in micrometers. Though this is not a detailed demonstration video, we'd like to take a few more minutes to show you the four graphic displays. We are now looking at a 3D color display of the beam profile, which you can manipulate or zoom in on using your PC mouse or pad. Next, we'll move to the 2D display, where you can add an ellipsoid. Then we'll select the XY plot and add a best fit Gaussian curve, a full width half max, and 1 over e squared lines. And finally, we'll move to the beam tracking display. Here you can observe the movement of the laser beam centroid with micron resolution. This is great for tracking the beam stability or beam steering over time and temperature. There are a couple more things I want to show you before we wrap this up. Let's look at the main control bar across the top of the software screen. It is divided into five parts: capture, file, buffer, computations, and info. Within each group, when you point the mouse at one of the features, you'll get a drop-down box with a brief explanation of its function. If you need more detailed help, just click on the Help button in the Info section, and you will access the full Beamage user manual. This completes our quick start video for our Beamage cameras. If you have any questions about this video or our unique Beamage cameras, please don't hesitate to contact us. Thanks for joining us today.